Welcome everyone, hope all is well. Some 2K21 next gen career mode hoops on Football Sunday. My Giants won earlier today, and hopefully Philly can hold on against Washington so we make the playoffs. But anyway, I appreciate you guys coming by for a good time. Last time out, we began year four, converted into the next gen, and were victorious over Toronto in the Air Canada Center, the first of many tough games to begin the year. I posted a line of 22, 8 assists, and only 3 missed shots. AD was everything as advertised, although Hart and Kately struggled, and if you guys know anything about this series, that was a big storyline last year for us. Gotta get those two going, and when they do, our offense looks scary. Now we open up at home against Charlotte and LaMelo Ball and Zion Williamson, who is on Charlotte in this series. We're feeling good. Back in the Smoothie King Center for the first time since we lost the NBA Finals, losing the last 3 games to Philadelphia. So trying to come out for the fans and put on a show in response to that heartbreaking series loss. So one game down, 81 games to go here in the fourth year of the road to the NBA series. Opening up against Zion and LaMelo Ball, who makes his NBA debut. It's great to be back here in the Smoothie King Center, the same place I've called home for my entire 4-year NBA stint, as apparently I think I'm Kevin Garnett all of a sudden, banging my head against the stanchion. So, but we have LaMelo Ball, hotshot prospect, we all know who he is, and I'm going to try to do my best to make him uncomfortable. Right when he crossed the half-court line, we'll be pressuring him. Anytime he's off the ball, I'm going to make it hard for him to operate. Never let the rookie get comfortable. That's my goal tonight, to lock him down. And it's also going to be a fun matchup to watch as Zion goes toe-to-toe with the unibrow inside and immediately off the jump. Josh Hart pokes a free from Gordon Hayward, but our transition offense has not been as big of a factor so far this year as it was in year three, especially in the playoffs. But I do get a screen from Anthony Davis driving on LaMelo, and I get the game started with a 3-point play, a nice little pick play off the secondary break, stepping up to the line, as that layup would further help my percentage here in the early goings of the season, 10 of 13 from the field, and I would also knock down the free throw. Charlotte would answer back thanks to threes from Hayward and Devontae Graham. Let's see if Kately has an answer for our side of things, and coming off of the screen, Kately knocks down another here in the early portion of year four. Now knotted up at 6, Zion with a head full of steam, but he dishes it around to Hayward, and somehow, someway, I get matched up on Zion, he knocks me over, but somehow he also misses the post hook. Not sure, I guess we got lucky there. Now up the other way, here comes Kately driving on Ball, and he finishes, and so far in this game, LaMelo Ball has missed 2 free throws. He's missed his only field goal opportunity, and now he gives up an and-1, so a tough start for the rookie, and now up 9-6, I allow him to get a little bit too much space there in the post. I was looking for the dish off, as he's been looking for his teammates a lot, as we all have expected here. But due to my cheating of the passing lanes, Ball records his first NBA points, and now a pick and roll between me and AD, a dish off, passing out of the jump shot to the unibrow as he puts another one in, 21-17, as we head near the end of the first quarter. And coming back in the second quarter with 6 minutes left to go. Once again, the bench not bad, up by 7 now as Hayward is unsuccessful at the charity stripe, driving on Devontae Graham, a hop step around him, and I'd put in another layup, giving me 7 points and 3 assists on the night. Great job from Josh Hart, taking advantage of the early break. LaMelo still not looking very comfortable here now in the second quarter as he gives this one up. I saw that pass coming, ripping it away from the rookie, and up the floor the outlet pass to AD, and he does it again. Puts another defender on his backside, this time it's Gordon Hayward, and with his injury history, kind of feel bad for that one for Gordon Hayward. Now up by 7 with 12 seconds left to shoot. This time, that's a beautiful bounce pass from LaMelo Ball. That's his 4th assist, and he's done that a lot tonight, so still Charlotte hanging around as it's still a 7-point game with 3 minutes left to go until halftime, as Hayward a little too careless with the drive as I also rip it away from LaMelo, and oh no, I see Zion coming, gotta get the layup off, and somehow I managed to outrun Zion on the break. Very surprised he didn't try to send that back off the backboard or something like that. Still up 7 as now Hart receives the pass, pulls it, and he knocks it down. Hart has been struggling so far this year, as I don't think I've even assisted to him once. But there's a long 3-4, the fourth year man out of Villanova. But thanks to their 3-point shooting, Charlotte's still hanging around as Hayward hits one. So once again, down by 7. as I receive a high pick from the unibrow. LaMelo Ball struggles to get around it, and that leads Anthony Davis with a free lane to do whatever he wants as he knifes his way and dunks over Zion, as Zion maybe getting a little bit of taste of his own medicine there, up by 14 as I hit the bench after that emphatic oop. So the bench once again helping to increase our lead. And once again, our vaunted Pelicans defense doesn't look like it missed a beat over the offseason. Tonight it's another game where we're holding the squad to 40% or under so far shooting, and once again we're limiting our three-point attempts. That seemed to work for us in the Toronto game, and it's working here too. 4-9 as a team from deep, and Anthony Davis and I are also winning our matchups versus LaMelo and Zion. The unibrow has 15 points, 6 rebounds, and 5 blocks versus Zion's 9-9. I also have 9 points, 50% shooting, 9 dimes, 4 steals, and LaMelo's line of 2 points, 5 assists, 1-3 shooting. I've been stifling him so far, and I also collect my first rebound of the contest. Josh Hart and Kately, though, 13 points, 5 of 11 shooting, so they've been pretty good tonight as well. But speaking of that, I drove past Zion, I had a lane, and the help defense came. Tried to record my first assist of the next gen to Josh Hart, but he can't handle the pass. Now up by 11. Pulling up after a screen from AD. We love going to that play on both sides of the floor. This time we run it on the right, and I knock down another jump shot. So far, so good in terms of shooting. My percentages are very high to begin year four. Zion getting trapped by Holmes and Davis, coughs it up, and here comes Josh Hart as he dishes it off to me as I put on the Jets and switching hands on Cody Zeller as the former fourth overall pick fouls me on the layup. And I have a chance for my second and one of the contest. And once again, no problems converting on another three-point play. So we continue to pull away now. Leads up to 16 as Terry Rozier checks in. He's had a really good start to the real NBA season. Coming off the bench for Charlotte in the series, however. Pass over to Kately, way downtown. And that actually went off the glass. That was my fault on the pass. I gave it to him way too far out, but the hot shot second year pro, my college teammate, still knocks it down with a little luck from the window. Now entering the fourth quarter, still up 16 as Graham with a tough shooting night, way short on that three. And now I'm getting pressured, but Cody Zeller switches on to me. And just like last game when I had Aaron Baines on me, let's see if I can break some ankles. And the step back gets him leaning. And now I try to attack while he's off balance. And nearly my third three-point play. But I do get fouled by Zion. And we see if I can add to my total of 14 at the charity stripe. And another look at that nice move right there. But speaking of which, I do think it's a little bit tougher in the next gen to make free throws, at least the user. I don't know if you guys have felt the same, but I kind of like it that way. I always thought I made a little bit too many whenever I played with this player, at least, but I do knock down the second. So one of two from the stripe that time, leaving my total at 15 as LaMelo takes it the other way, and quickly, it wouldn't take long for me to force a turnover. That's my fourth steal of the ball game, and now floating this one in over the 7-foot Cody Zeller, now 17 on the night for me, as we continue to pull away. And on this play, we've been running the pick and roll so much tonight, it's such a big part of our offense, but AD actually slips it. Rozier cheats on it, I guess they were expecting it, but in turn he leaves Aaron Kately to shoot a wide open corner three. And I'm also creeping up on my first double-double of the new season, currently at 9 assists with a couple of ticks left. And just like on the last possession, Rashawn Holmes setting me the screen, but he actually slips it. Very smart play, as Zeller was really cheating that. He was the hedge man, and he was all the way past the three-point line, so doesn't get much easier than that, as the lead swells to 20 points. And nearly wire-to-wire tonight, all Pelicans, as we return to home and get our business taken care of. 106-86 is your final. Behind my first double-double and 5 steals, Anthony Davis with another huge stat line on both on offense and defense. Rashawn Holmes locked down the interior, Kately and Hart combining for 23. Overall, just a great team win. Unibrow and I, we also won our matchups against our really tough opponents. I outclassed LaMelo, and I think Anthony Davis did a pretty dang good job on Williamson. And Marcus Uzada Silva, also coming off the bench, he struggled in the season debut, but 4-6. He was a big reason why our offense still managed to operate so well with me off the floor. Williamson ends the game with 14-14 in LaMelo, 4 points, and 6 assists with 4 turnovers in his NBA debut. was virtual debut at least, and that leads me to saying, I mean, hey, LaMelo didn't have a good real-life NBA debut either against Cleveland, but then again, he's also come back strong after that performance, and he's been putting together a pretty good rookie season so far, so I don't think that this game is going to be a red flag for him, and that leads me into our next opponent, the Dallas Mavericks, a team we have a lot of history with. As you guys know, we've gone to battle against Dallas twice in the playoffs, splitting the series 1-1. They beat us in the first round back in year 2, and in year 3 we came out victorious in the conference finals. I've got a pretty intense rivalry with Luka, and also DeSean Christian, of course, a hometown friend and college teammate. He is coming off a year where he averaged 20 points a game, and he struggled on opening night, but turned in a 17-point performance, really good performance at that, with a win over the Wizards. So the Mavericks also sit at 2-0, so battle of the unbeatens tonight, as I'm already at the arena in my game clothes. Ever since I stepped into the NBA spotlight, that's always what I've done. I've gotten to the arena early and I've always been the last one to leave. So back at home, as somebody has to get their first loss of the new year tonight, Pelicans and Mavericks. Always a fun time when these two teams take the floor against one another. Luka looks like Luka so far, 27 points a game versus my 19.5, 9 assists on my end, 6 assists for Luka, and look at DeSean's new haircut. He's always had that like little fro, you know, ever since I've known him, but he's really grown that out over the offseason. He's got that Kobe White haircut now, but anyway, back home again as Holmes wins his second jump ball of the episode, it's time to take the floor. And of course, one of the things you need if you're going to beat this sharpshooting Dallas Mavericks team is you got to try to outshoot them, as Kately, perfect job manipulating that screen, fading to the corner, and he will kick us off, give us our first lead, and our first assist of the night. So 6-5 Dallas as they make back-to-back threes. AD no good, nice defense from Maxi Kleba, and in transition, Richardson, the new acquisition, dishes to DeSean, who bangs it home, and so far it's been all Dallas Mavericks. 11-5 now, as we just cannot seem to get our offense on the board much, as there's Hardaway missing a three-pointer, looking for some early offense, but Dallas, full of athletes, they beat us up the floor, but I do take Hardaway to the rim, and thanks to the double clutch, I was able to avoid the weak side block from DeSean. Look, he rotated over, he's averaged over a block a game in his career, but a crafty finish gets it around my hometown buddy and former college teammate. So hopefully a play like that can help retain some momentum, as DeSean wouldn't take long for him to respond. However, really tough mismatch for us as Glenn Robinson checks in along with Luzada Silva and also Jahlil Okafor at the center position. DeSean pulls it again and Dallas continues to murder us from beyond the arc. Back up the other end, 17-9 as I call timeout. Gotta halt this momentum a little bit. And hopefully, like last game, the bench can give us a bit of a spark as I check out. And I think they do a pretty adequate job. Still in the game, down 5 as Anthony Davis pick and pop with Josh Hart as he knocks down his first 3 of year 4. And take a look at those stats at the bottom of your screen. If the season ended today, Anthony Davis would have career highs in rebounds and blocks a game. I know it's a very small sample size, but how about Okafor with the reverse jam as we continue to cut this lead down? Okafor has been pretty good so far in relief of Anthony Davis at the center position as Luka drives, and so far he has his fair share of points, but it's taken him a lot of shots. So far so good. And Kately on the other end, no good, but Okafor continues to provide a spark. Take a look at that full extension on the tip and over DeSean and Kristaps. So thanks to Okafor and some of the bench guys, we've cut this lead to 4, but now we need to play some defense, as so far Dallas has been killing us, but Kately comes up big with a steal. On the other end, dish up to Josh Hart. Can I finally get an assist to him? Yes! Finally an assist to Josh Hart on the new year. He's been struggling a little bit, only averaging around 7 points per game, which is about half of what he put out last season, but a big shot there, and we trim it to 1, as it looks like I'm going to be hitting the bench. Can the second unit hold? And yes, they do, and then some. How about a 6-point lead heading into the locker room? A big thanks to Marcos Luzada Silva, that guy right there, for that lead, as he actually led our team in scoring with 10 in the first half off the bench. Dallas actually started to cool off in the second. They've made 14 shots as a team, but 10 of them have been three-pointers, so we started to extend our defense further and picked up their shooters near half court. Everything else looks good though. We're out-rebounding Dallas by 9. The bench has played well because outside of Luzada Silva, Okafor has 8. Nikhil Alexander-Walker, the backup point guard, actually has 6 and 3 assists, out-dueling me. I only have 2, 3 rebounds, and 3 assists on 20% shooting. So a tough first half. Luka has 14, he's under 40%. And DeSean has 9 points and 4 rebounds as Anthony Davis off the dribble kicks us off. I guess he heard me talking about his perimeter shooting earlier on in the game. As I said, he's barely made any threes so far this year. But with that three, he also hit one in the first half. I guess he's starting to pick it up a little bit. So now up by 7, our largest lead of the game. A nice move on Luka as I dish it off to AD as the double team came. Good court vision there. And there's my fourth assist. Got to improve on my totals. This game has been pretty rough for me so far in the first half. Now leading by double digits with 6 minutes left to play off a screen, Luka. Maybe Dallas starting to go inside the perimeter a lot more. Only 4 field goals inside the three-point arc for them in the first half, and that's just not sustainable, so Dallas will look to get back in this game if they can get the ball inside more. Now a mismatch for AD. That's Josh Richardson on him as he converts the and one on the little guy. Anthony Davis, what an explosion to begin year 4. He continues to do it. Even against Dallas, a very tough team, both on the perimeter and in the interior. As once again, for some reason, Josh Hart's matching up against him, powering, puts his head down with the and one on back-to-back possessions as we start to pull away once again. So far, so good for my team. I'm just lucky that we're all playing so well in this game because I have not had it tonight. As DeSean, he's also starting to struggle. A tough day for him shooting after his hot start, just like me. Now on the other end, up by 13, high pick from Anthony Davis. I'm open once again. Can I end the dry spell? Wide open, but that one rims out. Head coach Anthony Thornton not losing his faith in me yet, as there's another screenplay to try to free me up. That one is another unfriendly roll, but Anthony Davis, just give him the ball and get out of the way. Over a bunch of players inside, a whole pack of them, that he punches it down on that one. He eclipsed 20 points on the night with that jam as we kick off the fourth quarter, up by 16. Did not think it would be this easy against Dallas, as now I have Richardson on me. Behind the back move doesn't work. Running a pick and pop with Nicolò Melli. This time from the corner, finally a shot drops. Only 6 points. I can't imagine the last time I finished under 10 points, and not only that, my playmaking hasn't been anything special as DeSean, with a cold spell of himself, he also knocks down a 3 to keep Dallas in the game a little bit. As a 15-point lead against most teams, you'd think to feel pretty safe, but not against Dallas. This is a team that can turn it on at any moment, and with no Luka on the floor, DeSean's actually playing point guard, and I left him too much space. A tough matchup for me as he's a lot quicker and about 6 inches taller. But a nice screen from Nicolò Melli, freeing me up for maybe the best look I'm going to have all night. As we continue to outpace Dallas, but this team with their 3-point shooting, now it's down to 7. 10 seconds left to shoot, Melli sets me another nice screen, got DeSean leaning just a little bit, but good help defense. 6 seconds left to shoot, stops me dead to rights. 2 seconds, Hart, shot clock, just off the mark. And once again, DeSean leading the attack. As he dishes this one over to Kristaps, steps into one over Kately, and that one rattles home. Just like that, Dallas is back within 5. As they continue to enjoy a 12-2 run, Dallas within 2 possessions. DeSean still on me, dribble handoff for Kately, fading, and he hits it! Wow, what a shot. That is another assist, my biggest of the night. My playmaking starting to step up here in the second half. Still no Luka for Dallas, but also still no Anthony Davis for us with 4.5 left to go. Down by 8, Dallas needs a stop. 4 seconds left to shoot, a hop step around DeSean, gets it done, furthering our lead. And maybe we can just hold on here, surviving Dallas' big run. The unibrow finally back in along with Luka as he slips this pick and roll. He's open, and how about that use of the pivot foot? Wow, what a huge 3-point play. As Anthony Davis has shown a lot of power here in the early goings of season 4, but that one was all finesse. What a use of the pivot foot as Luka with the pull-up 3 the other way. as off Anthony Davis's missed free throw, he gets an early opportunity to stroke one, so up by four. And it looks like coach wants to go back to Aaron Cayley. He's been so good tonight, made almost every three, but not this time. And even though you can't make every shot you take on offense, you can always play defense, and that's something Rashawn Holmes knows very well. Sneaky steal on Luka, lobbing it up to Holmes. Oh my goodness. Oh, Luka sits down. And I actually wanted to lob Anthony Davis, but all of a sudden Holmes knifing down the paint, he steals it. And Luka on a poster. Oh my goodness, save the women and children. Oh man. And I don't know how Holmes and Anthony Davis didn't get a technical for celebrating right on top of Luka. That's got to be taunting or something. But the ref, I guess, I mean, she's looking right at it, but I guess, hey, they let him play and they let them enjoy the moment and let us enjoy the moment, as somehow we do hold on against Dallas despite their red hot fourth quarter. As this caps off maybe my first disappointing performance of the new season, 14 points, 4 rebounds, 8 assists. And I actually shot 4 of 7 in the second half, so pretty good response, but 5 turnovers, so not my best night by any means. And Anthony Davis, really the only starter to really have a good game on offense, 26 and 16 for the unibrow, as the bench once again saved us in this game. Look at these performances from our bench players, and it's really a nice refreshing change of pace compared to last season, especially in the playoffs, how up and down they were. Luka had 30, but he took 30 shots as well, so I did a pretty good job on him, only 2 assists as well. DeSean had a tough night, but he did rebound well after his tough second and third quarters to keep the Dallas Mavericks in it with his electrifying fourth, 15 points for the fourth year pro. But this caps off Dallas's first loss of the season as we remain undefeated 3-0, taking that sparkling record into the same arena that I started my NBA career in, the Target Center here in Houston, against the new look Houston Rockets, as John Wall, of course, he joins Harden in that backcourt. They currently sit at 1-1 on the new season, as their only loss was to DeSean and the Mavericks so far. And it's always nice to come back here, and I remember my NBA debut like it was yesterday. I had 4 points and 7 assists, as I take pretty good totals here despite my tough game last time out. 17.5 points, almost 9 assists, and that assist total is good for 6th in the NBA right now. But I do have to say, it is seeming to be a little bit harder to get assists here in the next gen, which I like the challenge, definitely. I was able to average over 13 in the playoffs, as there's a nice look over my shoulder to the cutting unibrow to kick us off tonight. But yeah, I do like the defense seems to be very well strengthened by 2K in the next gen, and I've enjoyed the challenge of getting assists to my teammates as I begin this game with a jump shot from 15 feet. And hopefully we can get a win tonight just like we did in my NBA debut in this building, as we beat the Rockets by over 15 points. I remember that rookie team was pretty crazy. We used to have Julius Randle and Elfrid Payton, guys like that. But Harden kicks off Houston, recording 2 out of the first 3 buckets. The NBA returning leading scorer at 34.5 a night, outdueling guys like Bradley Beal, Lillard, and the MVP Giannis. So we'll see if the second year pro Aaron Cayley can hang with him, as Josh Hart gets a steal, gives it back to me leading the charge, and here's a handoff to AD with a left-handed throwdown for my second assist of the outing. And I feel like Houston and Dallas play a lot alike on offense. We're gonna have to continue to shoot to keep up with Houston, as look at Hart off the dribble, and he knocks it down for my third assist of the night. Josh Hart struggling to begin this year, but maybe he's starting to turn it around a little bit. As even last night, only 2 of 7 shooting against Dallas, as I check out, come back in, and with the bench playing so well last game, they were due to cool off a little bit. Only 17 points as a team in the first quarter, and a big reason why Houston has the lead is John Wall was killing our backup guards, as on this possession, a missed jump shot as I've continued to struggle shooting the ball after my first made field goal. Anthony Davis has my back, however. Now down by 8 as Cayley drives, dishes it back to me with 14 seconds left to shoot as I hand it back off to him. Cayley from downtown, there's another 3-pointer keeping us in the game. Now down by 6 as Houston still on the attack. John Wall was red hot in the first quarter after I checked out. Let's see if he can do it again with the double clutch, and he looks like he's still in his prime with Washington. 10 points for Wall so far tonight, as now I'm starting to have trouble containing the ninth year man out of Kentucky. And now a good screen from Anthony Davis. I keep Wall on my back hip, and there's a nice assist to Anthony Davis. And so far, no matter what team we've played, every team has had struggles containing AD in the painted area. Still down by 8, however, as John Wall continues to lead the charge as he oops this one up to Christian Wood. And we've had so many posters in our favor, but finally I'm put on one as Christian Wood, the former Detroit Piston, punches it down, and that further adds frustration to my tough night, and the bench doesn't exactly help at all either. 59-45, Houston shooting near 60% from the floor as they've been tearing up our vaunted Pelicans defense. Still down 16. Quick screenplay from AD. I give it off to him, and I actually didn't call for this ball. A little surprised he was able to get that back to me, but after a little twirl, finally my second field goal of the night drops. So now down by 13 with almost half of the third quarter elapsed. I give the screen to AD, who has a lane on Tucker, and how about Anthony Davis? He has his revenge on Christian Wood for throwing one down on me. Anthony Davis, one of the best teammates you could have, always has my back, as Harden well short on the three-point. Former MVP has just not had it tonight. It's really been John Wall's night, but a nice job moving without the ball, AD, but he misses the point-blank layup. He does recover and drop it through, but once again, just really tough to get assists here in the next gen, as I really thought that one was going to be one, but we do cut it to single digits after that layup, but it wouldn't take long for Houston to respond as we're still down 15. No look pass to you-know-who, the unibrow, this one punching it down on Chris Clemens. But coming back in the fourth quarter, things are starting to get a little ugly. It's now a 29-point game as I try to take this one on Clemens. Tough finish in the paint, but somehow I do manage to drop that one in, breaking into another double-digit performance, although with really tough shooting lines from everywhere on the court. But Kaitley picks this pass off. We're just playing for pride at this point. Things didn't really get much better since the second half started, as I'm fading out of bounds. A nice highlight play at least to take us to the end of this game. Only a few more plays to go over. 102-86 right now is Harden. Yep. Harden just doing what he does. 108-82 now. Coming back up the other way, as one more basket for me, as there's a nice double clutch, that time on DeMarcus Cousins, who checks in. But these plays would serve as nothing more than just stat patterns, as we drop this game by over 20 points here in the Target Center, the same arena that I made my NBA debut in as a rookie, and it felt like tonight I was back as a rookie the way I played. Anthony Davis and Aaron Kaitley led the way, but outside of that, just not a lot of offense manufactured, as 4 out of my 6 field goals came in the 4th quarter. Outside of that, I was a whopping 2 of 11. So, once again, a tough shooting performance, and that performance in the 4th quarter just came too late. I did end up chipping in 11 assists and 6 rebounds, but a fairly frustrating night here in Houston to hand us our first loss of the year. But on the bright side, we do take 3 out of 4 to begin the new year, as we just need to overcome my struggles from shooting these last two games, and Josh Hart picking up his slack as well. I don't know what's going on with him. He just does not seem like the same player as last year, and I also got completely outclassed by John Wall, so my first bad defense performance of the new year comes in this loss. But so far 3-1, near the top of the West, and near the top of the West in defensive ratings as well. So defense seems to be up to snuff, and the unibrow seems to be up to expectations as well. 27 points, and if he ended the season today, he'd have career highs and rebounds of 14 and blocks with 3. Despite my tough back-to-back shooting nights, my line is respectable. 16.5 points, 9.5 assists, 2 steals, but I gotta trim down the turnovers as well. I've never averaged more than 3 giveaways a game in my career for a season, but I'm close to 4 a night right now. Kaitley's been solid, but I think his field goal percentage is a little misleading for how he's played on offense, and it's looking like his defense has taken the next step as well for how well he played on Devontae Graham and James Harden. Holmes has been solid, and the bench outside of the Houston game has taken a huge step in the right direction. Josh Hart, though, it's still early, but he's been completely invisible in offense, and that'll be key going forward. As the next time here in the series, we're going to be doing some simulating. We got to go up against the healthy Klay Thompson and the Warriors twice. Brooklyn with Kyrie and Durant. Portland with Donny G. The Lakers with Ferron. I mean, yeah, this is a very tough schedule. A lot of great defensive teams, including Miami and Toronto once again. Can Josh Hart and I overcome our shooting slumps to win some games? Find out next time. Hopefully we can stay hot. And stay tuned, everybody. Take care of yourselves.